Spreaker, hello, good morning. How are you doing? Yes, that is exactly the way I really love to wake you up in the morning. Hello, good morning. How are you doing? How was your night? Hope you slept well. Did you dream about me? Or did you dream about someone else? Anyways, I'm not jealous. I'm not jealous, not at all. If you dreamt about someone else, it's all right. It's not no problem. I just have to find a way to deal with you. Somehow, you know, somehow. Okay, happy Sunday. Is someone in church? Well, if you're in church, that means you won't be listening to me. So you're either at home getting ready to go to church or you're already back from church. You know, there are some churches that really close quite early, especially the Catholic churches and you know, some of the churches, even some Pentecostal churches, they close very, very, very early. They have like 3 or 4 or 6, 7 services. And some people go for the very first services that closes by 6:30, 7 o'clock and you're done. Whichever one, I believe that you're just somewhere at home or at a friend's place, anywhere there that's quite quiet and you're listening to me right about this moment. All right, welcome to this great episode of Bristol Call. Yes, this is always our first official program of the day every morning. Okay, and Rooster Call is a program, like I always say, it's a program that is all about positive vibes and positive energy. Okay, it's a program that helps you start off your day. It's a program that gives you new perceptions, new perspectives towards life. It helps you, it tells you how you should look at life, okay, and how you can apply it to your day-to-day living. Right, so who is ready for positive vibes? Do I go ahead and bring the action? Because today on Rooster Call, I'm really going to be talking about something that could take you through the week, not just the week, through the month, not just the month, through the year, not just through the year, and just through your entire life. Okay, it is very, very important, and you should not even you should not only listen to it, but you should also share it out to some of the persons that really might really want to, you know, hear something like this. All right, moving straight ahead to the programming proper. Do I go ahead and bring the action? Someone tell me to bring the action right about now. Right, I'm ready for the action. Are you ready for the action? Because that's exactly what you're telling me right now, that you are ready for the action. All right, so today on positivity, today on positive energy, today on Rooster Call, what are we going to be talking about? We are going to be talking about thinking positive, okay? Thinking positive. All right, look, you're entering a new week, okay, because today marks the beginning of a new week, okay, and I don't want you to go into the new week without thinking positive. I don't want you to go into the new week with negative vibes and negative energy all over you. You know, I want you to go into the new week looking at life from a different, more open and better positive perceptions and perspectives. I want you to go into the new week ready to touch someone's life positively, ready to do great and positive things, ready to think positive, you know, ready to act, talk, everything just positively, because it just makes life all the more better, all the more sweeter, makes you look forward to every day. All right, so I'm just going to be talking about thinking positive, and I've got me a compilation of quotes that will buttress that point, as we usually do it right here. Compilation of quotes from really, really great, experienced, famous quoters who have gone through life, who have gone through the hell and heaven of it, and they just decided that, you know what, no matter what, just keep it positive. All right, so I want to make sure let this positive vibes and positive quotes actually remind you of the benefits of being positive, okay? Because being positive means that you will look forward to life, forward to future with good expectations. All right, so the very first quote I've got here is by Angel Green, and she said, positive
emotions act as a personal development spur, whereas negative thinkers are more likely to give up when things don't go according to plan. When you are a positive person with positive energy and positive vibes, no matter how many times you fail, you will never give up. But people who think negatively, they always give up at the slightest falter. Okay, all right, now the next one here is by Side Casados, and he said, when you take a positive action, a positive feeling generally follows it. Okay, when you take a positive action, a positive feeling generally follows it, okay, which is then most likely followed by another positive action, and that's how the circle goes. When you take a positive action, it comes along with a positive feeling, and because it comes along with a positive feeling, and because it comes along with a positive feeling, you go ahead and take another positive action. And because that positive action comes with a positive feeling, and that's how it just goes on and on and on. All right, we are still here on the show. And this next one here is by another great author, Otto Danosa. And he said, every day may not be a good one, but there is something good in every day. Okay? Every day may not be a good one, but there is something good in every day. So keep it positive no matter what. All right, the next one here is by Swati Shiv, and he said, complaining and worrying would release negative hormones in your body and harm your health, whereas focusing on positive aspects of your life would increase and release positive hormones in the body and improve health and happiness. Do you know that your ability to think positive is one way or the other connected to your health and total well-being? You know, when you're always worried about something, your health gets to deteriorate. Either you have high BP or body temperature goes higher than normal, you know, something like that. But when you are always positive, when you're always calm, trying to look at things from a better perspective, you get to find out that, okay, your health, even if you were sick, just get to find out you are on a cool down basis. You understand what I'm saying? All right, if you're just tuning in, this is Rooster Call right here on yours truly, solely for your listening pleasure, Vicky Lonia Radio. And on the MRC is the queen of the MRC, your one and only radio host, Vicky Lonia, and no one does it better than I do. All right, still moving on. And what we are looking at today on Rooster Call is positive vibes. Yes, positive thinking. Keep it positive, always. We are starting a new week and we need positivity to go through it. All right, this next one here is by Ralph Waldo, and he said, speak the affirmative, emphasize your choice by utterly ignoring of all that you reject. Okay, speak the affirmative, emphasize your choice by utterly ignoring all of that you reject. All right, quite explanatory. And next one here is by Steve Palvina. Okay, Pavlina, all right? Pavlina, he said, depression is disempowering, but positive emotions are empowering. Depression is disempowering. Negative energy is disempowering, but positive emotions are empowering. Do you want to be disempowered or empowered? The choice is yours. All right, this next one here is by Laurie Hagner, and he said, choose to look at the positives within challenging situations. Choose to look at the positivity within challenging situations. Choose to look at the positivity within challenging situations. Okay? No matter how bad a situation is, there is always a good side to a bad situation. Now, until you look at that good side, you'll not be able to get out of that situation. All right, the next one here is by Neely Stapleton, and he said, there is a positive vibe to any situation, even if you don't see it right away. Just exactly what Larry Hagner said. All right, still moving on. I've got me this one here by Robert Gallagher, and he said, situations like being promoted at workplace, becoming a mother or a father, moving to a new home, you know, and all of that may be positive aspects of our lives, but we experience some sort of stress in situations like that. So always make sure that when there is a change in your life, try to look at it from the positive side, all right? Because the stress that comes with change is really, really normal, okay? There is stress that comes with change. There is a skeptical vibe that comes with change. There is this negative energy that comes with change. But if you dwell on that negative side, if you dwell on that negative energy, it's not going to help you at all. So please make sure that you always try to see the positivity in every negativity. Good. Alright, this show is still Rooster Call, and we are looking at the compilation of quotes about how to keep your thinking positive. Alright, this next one here is by Drew Eubanks, and he said, "Turn the negative into positive and use the knowledge gained to propel you further." Turn the negative into positive and use the knowledge gained to propel you further. Okay, that is quite explanatory, self-explanatory. And the next one here is by Benjamin Chopin, and he said, "The mind, like the sponge, can only put out what it takes in. Powerful. The mind, like the sponge, can only put out what it takes in. Thus, we have to be sure to soak up positive thinking in order to produce the positive results." Exactamente. Exactly. This is quite a powerful one. And this one here again is by Brian Deeb, and he said, "Accountability implies a freedom to do something. It moves beyond the mere absence of interference or coercion and implies a definite sphere with which an individual can act to get things done. In this sense, make sure a person is free to make a positive contribution towards their organization." All right, this basically applies to business owners, CEOs, founders, business, anything that has to do with business and entrepreneurial capabilities. Okay, so when you have people working under you, just make sure that they are not forced. There is freedom in the place, okay? Because freedom brings about positive energy and positive vibes. Alright, it is still Rooster Call, and we are looking at how to keep positive thoughts as part of your life. Keep it positive at all times. And we have been looking at a compilation of quotes, and I hope that this quotes are really going a long way to touching you and, you know, giving you and opening your mind to better possibilities and better positivity. All right, I had this last one here, which happens to be a favorite of mine. This is by Mark Sidner to close up the show. He said, "Make it a habit to notice the positive things from your workmates, okay? And soon you will be more productive when working together." Make it a habit to notice the positive things from your workmates, and soon you'll be positive, you'll be more productive when working together. Yes, be positive in everything you do. That is number one. Try to spread the positivity here and there. That is number two. And trust me, when you are positive and when you are around positive people in your workplace, in your home, in school, at the marketplace, wherever it is you are, hanging out with friends, when positivity beats positivity, it's always positivity all the way, right? Great. So tell me, who else is enjoying the show like I am enjoying it? Me, I am. Alright, that is exactly all I've got for you today on the program Rooster Call. Keep it positive at all times. And please try to share this podcast with other people. Somebody out there might really, really want to, you know, might really need this sort of admonishment, okay? Admonishment and all that. Okay, so share it out to other people so that is, you know, it's just the first way. This is the first step to, you know, being positive. All right, I do hope that you have a great positive week, and let's do this again tomorrow at exactly this time. And trust me, it's going to be another great motivational energy, positive energy given topic tomorrow on the program Rooster Call. All of Mr. Men's Vicky Lonia, the Queen of the MRC, and still keep a look right here on Vicky Lonia Radio, because I've got me much more interesting programs for you. Do not forget, it's Sunday. I hope you went to church. Get your dancing shoes ready, because right about now we are moving straight into the grooving time. Yes, let us sing hallelujah to the Lord. Let us dance, and let us sing. Let's clap, shake your waist, jaw. It's not only in the club, you shake your waist. Go on, shake your waist for Jesus Christ, jaw. All right, that's all I've got for you. Thank you so much for being a part of the show. And I will be signing out with this great song by Alexandra Burke, which is titled Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lord. And that's all I got. Ciao, ciao now. She broke her throne.